Would you like to have a course from Harvard listed in your CV? Take CS50. And this is not an advertisement, okay? I just found this super cool course. It's called CS50. It is online course. It is from Harvard and it's like completely free. Or taking the course is completely free. If you would like to get a verified certificate, you would need to pay for it, but you know, maybe you don't really need a verified certificate. The full name of this course is Introduction to Computer Science, and simply to say, it's about programming. If you know how to program, this course will be like super easy for you, and you know, it may look really good in your CV. If you don't know how to program, or you would like to become better in programming, then it's not only about having this course in your CV, but you can actually find this course super useful. By the way, I'm taking this course, so I know what I'm talking about. And the course is like very well prepared, and even I know how to program, or I know a little bit about programming already. I still really enjoy this course, because I like the challenges, I like the examples, I like the activities. It's like, it's fun, yeah. So let's have a closer look at this course. You can access this course even without signing up. Just go here on this website, explore the course, watch the videos, have a look at the activities. But if you would like to submit your code, you need to register for the course. It means search for CS50 free, go on the Harvard's website, click on Learn More, and activate the course on edX. Then the links from edX will bring you back to the pages which are accessible without registration, but it looks like the button to ask for the certificate is only on the edX website, okay? And also, if you would like to submit the code, you really will need to register on edX, because when you are submitting the code for like very, very first time, you need to fill up a form and you need to tell them your edX username. So I think it's somehow connected together. When we have a closer look at the course, there are 11 lessons, or they call it weeks. Basically, each week has a video that you watch. Then you work on problem sets or labs. These are the activities you need to do. For example, the week zero was about programming in Scratch, and to finish this lesson, you need to create your own game. And even if you have never ever programmed before, in the week zero, you will create your own simple game. Like, wow, I have never used Scratch before, and I created this mini golf game, and it was like super simple. I really, really spent more time making this small game as I originally planned, because I had like so much fun and I found it like super interesting. The next lesson is called C. And instead of playing with blocks like it was in week zero, you actually start writing some code. The course is laser focused on programming, but on the way, you will also learn a lot of other things. For example, you will learn how to use the command line in Linux, because that's basically how you will be compiling your code, and how you will be submitting your code for approvals and checking the code, yeah? They will always explain everything. They will give you like step-by-step instructions about how to create and run the code in Linux. You will also learn a lot of background about how computers work and how they think. This is like super cool, because when I was learning all this, I found one piece of the information in books. The other part of the information was on internet. I learned some at the university, but here it's all in one place. And That's what I believe makes this course super useful. It is like very, very well structured. It goes step by step through the things you need to know, and it goes through these steps in the right order. Very important. It goes in the right order so you are sure you know everything you need to know to fully understand what you are going to learn. Okay? It's super important because it makes the learning much easier. In the week one, I really enjoyed working on this credit card problem. You will need to write a code which, based on credit or debit card number, will tell you who is the card provider and if the number is valid. So you will not only learn programming, but also some other useful information. For example, now I know that if you have a Visa card, that your card number probably starts with number 4. Am I right? My Visa card really starts with number 4. I'm not going to talk about every single lesson. Here in this left menu, you can see what the course is about. It covers all the essential programming languages and every time you will need to work on some activities. I'm still on the week 2, and to write the code, I didn't have to install anything. Everything is done in your browser, and this is how it looks. You will be using something what is called CodeSpace from GitHub, and in the lessons you will exactly find these step-by-step instructions what to do. Usually it looks like this. You go inside of your workspace, you download some code, so you don't have to always write everything from complete zero. Yeah, you don't write everything from scratch. Often you only write the part of the code which you are learning about in that specific lesson. And then you can run some commands which will tell you if your code is doing exactly what is required and if the style of your code is right. You know, if your code, if what you created looks as what is expected from a good or professional programmer. And once all this pass, once everything is okay, then you just simply submit your code. And that's basically how the course works and looks. You watch a video, then based on some instructions, you work on some activities. If they are programmed correctly and pass some tests, then you can submit your work. I'm not at the end of the course yet, but it looks like by the end of the course, you will need to work on your final project. And I'm really looking forward to work on this because for a very long time, I wanted to create one website, but I just could not convince myself to do it. So now I will have the reason to do it. And finally, I really hope I will create a website. So if you have an idea for a project or website you always wanted to create, but could not convince yourself to do it, maybe taking this course can help you to make it happen. Go for it. Yeah, create it, build it. In the description of this video, I attach all the important links, and basically that's it. In the comments, let me know if you may be taking this course and if you found this video helpful. Don't forget, if you like this video, then press like button. If you would like to see my future videos, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Bye.